Many actors can make the transition from big-budget Hollywood movies to acclaimed rock star, but Jared Leto has managed to do just that with his band 30 Seconds to Mars.
Yeah, they sold more than 5 million albums and launched the latest single, 230 Miles from Earth, on the International Space Station. We'll talk about that in a second.
Yeah, he joins us now, but first, welcome to you. Lovely to see you on the sofa
so
bright and early in the morning. We're really looking forward to hearing about Up in the Air, so shall we hear it first?
Yeah.
A few more than Up in the Air there. We've got value, Jared.
My entire life just flashed before my eyes. It was great.
Fantastic.
So Up in the Air, we alluded to it there, but it was played up in the International Space Station. I mean, how on earth did that come about?
I have no idea. I got lucky. I had this crazy idea, like many of us do, but I decided to do something about it rather than just think about it. I thought, how great would it be to celebrate this new chapter of our lives by sending our song to space? So I picked up the phone and called NASA after I figured out how to get in touch with them and kind of presented our case, and they said yes. So we sent it 261 miles to the space station and had our debut from space.
That is so cool.
Yeah,
what,
it was
really
cool.
I mean, what was it like when you heard it then playing from
it
space?
It was incredible. We actually went to NASA twice. We went to Cape Canaveral the first time to watch the rocket go up, which was astounding. Unlike anything I'd ever seen. They packed our CD in this giant rocket ship with 5,000 pounds of scientific gear. And then we went back a week and a half later and debuted this song from Mission Control in Houston.
Wow. I've got a vision of the astronauts on board putting it into the CD player at the front of, you know, in the cockpit, listening to it.
You know what? You're really not too far off.
There
was a moment I was talking to the astronaut about life in space. I'm in Mission Control. I'm on this phone from the 1960s. It was all very bizarre and amazing. And in the middle of our conversation, he reached out and he grabbed something and he spun it around in zero gravity, and it was our CD.
Wow.
That our mouths just hit the floor. It was great, yeah.
And the video is really interesting as well. We saw a little bit of it there, but pure artwork and zebras feature. I mean, how did you put that together?
Zebras, as we say, lions, yeah. Wolves, Dita Von Teese, Damien Hirst, and the Olympic, the U.S. female Olympic gymnastics team. It's really just a collection of things that I love, things that I'm curious about, and a celebration of art and design and life itself.
Because for you, 30 Seconds to Mars, it's more than a band, isn't it? I mean, you want to make it about your art and design and film and all of that to come together under this brand.
Yeah, I think that's pretty right on. I'm an art school dropout myself. I dropped out in the third year. I always wanted to be an artist, but I've thought about 30 Seconds to Mars as a place not just to make music, but to make art in general. Yeah,
and hugely popular band as well. But also,
thank you very much.
Well, you're welcome. Very, very well recognized actor, and we're going to be seeing a new film with you in coming out later in the year.
I took 5 years off. We were just busy touring. We toured actually so much we got the Guinness World Record for the longest tour ever, which we weren't trying to do. No sane person should try to do that. We were on the road for about 2.5 years, but time flew, and I didn't make a film for 5 years. So recently I made a film in December called Dallas Buyers Club, and I played a transsexual woman I waxed my body from head to toe and spent a lot of time in high heels.
What was it like wearing high heels?
I was a natural, I gotta say.
He's wearing them today, you can't see them. But
there we are. Yeah, exactly. We can see a picture of you there. So we'll be seeing you looking like that in the film.
And you had to lose weight for this role, significant amount of weight. I mean, you've had weight gain and loss issues for roles, haven't you?
Yeah.
Several times now. Yeah. Is that something that's... You feel, obviously in this case, you had to do it.
It really depends on the part. In this case, I was playing a transsexual woman who was dying of AIDS and also a drug addict. So I thought it was appropriate to probably lose a little bit of weight. I ended up losing a lot of weight. Mm. But really, it does something to you. It's not just about the way that it looks. It's the way that it makes you walk, the way that it makes you talk, the way it makes you feel. It was intense, and it'll be out, I think, in December.
Towards the end of the year here, I think.
What's been the impact of losing all that weight for the role? Then when you go back to perhaps eating normally, was that difficult?
It's not easy. It's a little dangerous. Your body certainly gets confused. But I usually just go back on tour, and that keeps me a bit, gets me in shape. I mean, when you're on the stage running around like madmen, like we do, as you can see from those little clips, it's a pretty energetic show. And we're very excited. We just played our first show on this side of the pond, so to speak, the other day for BBC Radio 1 Big Weekend, and it was great. We'll be coming back later this year, too. But it's a huge week for us. Our brand new album, Love, Lust, Faith, and Dreams, is out now. We worked on it for 2 years. And I think it's the best thing that we've ever done.
I was going to ask you whether you prefer to be known as a musician or as an actor, but I think I sense it's musician, isn't it? Is that your first
love? I like what Andy Warhol said, labels are for cans, not for people. And I think that was very well said. You know, I do a lot of different things with my life. I direct, I act, I make films as a producer as well. I spend a lot of time doing interviews too.
Thank you so much.
Professional interview.
We will not label your can again.
Yes.
Thank you very much indeed. Jared Leto, thank you very much indeed for coming in. And the album Love, Lust, Faith and Dreams out, and the dates of the UK tour will be announced very shortly as well.
Yeah, but let's find out what's happening where you are. Our last look.
Good morning.